Why are you so gay?
Why are you gay?
Who says I'm gay?
You are gay.
Oh, shit. Natural selection surely would suggest that a trait like homosexuality, which goes directly counter to the evolutionary goal of procreation, would be eliminated from the general population. Gayness is a Darwinian paradox. I wanted to try to answer this question, so I started looking at the sociobiology of gayness. There's been a great deal of research that seems to suggest that the more older brothers a male has from the same mother, the higher the chance he'll turn out gay. The more sons that are born, the odds of the next son being gay increases by a whopping 38 to 48%. This is called the fraternal birth order effect. And we don't see it play out in families with adopted or step-older brothers. We only see it play out with biological brothers. Many scientists believe this suggests that gayness is determined, at least in part, in the womb. It may be a maternal immune response, where the mother's fetus neutralizes certain Y proteins that affect sexual differentiation, leaving certain parts of the brain responsible for sexual orientation in a more female-typical state. In fact, in a 2017 study, mothers with gay sons were indeed found to have higher levels of antibodies to those Y proteins than mothers with only heterosexual sons. The idea is, the more sons that are born, the more chances the mother's body has had to activate antibodies in response to those Y proteins. So why on earth would this effect have been selected for evolutionarily? Why would it be that the more sons someone births, the less likely they'll end up procreating? Well, it raises the question of a gay person's function in society. And I'm going to take off my scientist hat now and put on my philosopher's hat. Gunkles. As adjunct child rearers, gay people help lighten the load for the rest of the family, which in turn helps preserve the genetic lineage, a trait that would indeed be naturally selected for over time. But what about gays who hate kids? We've all seen them sloppy drunk at brunch, complaining about the terrible 2-year-old at the neighboring table. Well, gay people are also often tastemakers and diplomats. In fact, one study argues that gayness is part of a whole suite of traits responsible for social integration and pro-social behavior. Traits like reduced reactive aggression, increased social affiliation, play, and social communication. In other words, being charismatic, fun, having a love of the theater, and hosting great dinner parties. I mean, after all, the function of sex is not just to procreate. It's also a bonding ritual. One we see play out significantly in bonobo society, for example. No, not the company with sleek button-downs and floral socks, though I do like their tailored suits. Bonobos, the monkey species that uses sex as a part of its social relations, and not just between males and females. Bonobos use sex to settle arguments and to bond, instead of aggression. Sound familiar? There's yet another theory floating around that gayness is the result of a group of genes that normally serves reproductive benefits gone haywire and run amok. The theory states that a low dose of certain alleles might help folks pick a well-suited mate to raise their children. For example, it might be evolutionarily advantageous for men to find certain masculine features attractive in women. But every so often, those genes overserve their purpose and result in an extreme masculinization or feminization of a gay or lesbian person's model of attraction. Now, these are just a few possible arguments for gayness from an evolutionary perspective, though they are some of the ones I found most convincing. At the end of the day, however, we may never know why we are the way we are. Sometimes I wonder if I'm only asking these questions as a defensive gesture. After all, it's harder to find message boards full of people asking the question, why are there red-haired people? There's no evolutionary reason for folks to have red hair. The truth is, there are huge chunks of the population that want to challenge the very notion of queerness and even erase us from public life. So I'm left doing research to try and defend the position that gayness is in fact a natural process, does serve a function to our society, and is in fact here to stay and here to slay. I'll catch you folks next time on Curious About Everything. And if nobody told you they love you today, neither do I. See ya.